Hey guys, it's Brian, and today I'm going to give you a couple tips that may be useful when you're replacing a water pump. All right, now you may be asking yourself, why would I want to replace my water pump? Well, if you listen to this, that's a good indication your water pump needs to be replaced because it's not supposed to be making a sound like that. Now, you may not be able to hear that sound over your engine, so in that case, it might take a trained professional to go through a couple of steps to figure out if your water pump needs to be replaced. However, I've had this truck for quite a while, and I started noticing a hum that I hadn't heard before, so by process of elimination, take a couple belts off, figure out, you know, where the hum's coming from, I was able to determine that my water pump indeed needed to be replaced. Alright, so the first thing you're going to need to remove in order to get to your water pump and all that crazy stuff is your necklaces. I mean, your belts. Not your necklaces. Your belts. You'll basically have 3 to 4 belts if you're working on this particular vehicle. I only have 3 on mine because I'm not using the smog pump or the emissions control pump. It went out on me a long time ago and it was just a hassle, so I thought, you know, I'm passing emissions just fine. I don't need the smog pump, so I'm not using it. So I have 3 belts on my vehicle. The belts that I'm currently using are for the power steering, the air conditioning, and the alternator. So basically, this is the belt that goes around the power steering. We got that off. This is the belt that goes around the air conditioning and the alternator. It goes around both of them. And this one basically does the same thing. So make sure you remove your belts. You'll need, obviously, proper tools for that, so remove your belts. The next step is to drain the antifreeze from the radiator. The reason is because if you don't, you're going to have a big mess when you take your water pump off. So what I like to do is I like to jack the truck up a little bit, stick this tub underneath the radiator, and it's a perfect way to drain it because I know this tub is deep enough to where I'm not going to overflow the tub. And also, it doesn't allow it to go all over the ground to where animals can get to it, because that's not, number one, environmentally friendly. It's not good for animals either. So. Then after that, I basically call a buddy of mine that has his own automotive garage, and take it over to him. He puts it in his big tub. It's the best thing for the environment, so consider that when you're draining your radiator. Next step, remove the fan from the water pump. And this is a pretty simple step. Basically, what you have to do is on the back of the fan, there's these 4 notches. There are screws that go through those notches and into your water pump. So basically, get the correct wrench and remove your fan. All right, so the next step is to figure out how many screws you have holding the water pump in place. So what I like to do is I like to get my new water pump out and put it up to where I can actually see how many screws need to be replaced. Now, this particular water pump is my old water pump, because I already have the new one installed, but you'll see that you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 screws. Okay, so how am I keeping this water pump in place? This is another tip. If you take this right here, this basically holds your belts, and when the water pump is on the vehicle, it goes on like this. What I like to do is I like to get my new water pump out, set this down on the ground, and put the new water pump on there. Then, when you're taking screws out of the old water pump from the vehicle, you can take the screws and put them in the holes where you know they're going to go. Then, when you get ready to put the new water pump on the vehicle, you have all these screws in the new water pump, just take them out and basically swap places, put the old water pump on this little stand, and put the screws back into the holes where you know they're going to go, and that way you know you're going to get the screws back into the place where they need to be on the vehicle. All right, now that you know how many screws hold the water pump in place, you also need to be aware that 3 of those screws go through this plate right here, this big metal plate, and into the water pump and then into your vehicle. So basically, those 3 screws are located down here where the water pump is, on the bottom of the plate. There's also a few screws that need to be removed in order to get the plate off after you remove those. There's one on top of the air compressor. There's two on the bottom of the air compressor down here. Then you have to take the alternator off. There's two screws to take the alternator off. One is a tensioning rod, and then one is a screw on the bottom of the alternator. Then there is a bracket on the back side next to your dipstick for your oil. There's a bracket, and then the tube, there's a tube that the screw on the bottom of this bracket goes through. Make sure you don't lose that tube. That's important. And then I'll take you over to the other side of the vehicle here, and there's some screws that need to be removed in order to get the water pump off from the smog pump. So let me go ahead and do that now. Alright, basically I'm giving you a point of view from the passenger side looking across the engine towards the driver's side. Alright, so focus your attention over here where my hand is. On the bottom of the water pump, there's a screw that goes through the plate that holds your power steering pump, then it goes into the water pump. That will have to be removed. Then there are two more screws here that go through the plate that holds your smog pump and into the water pump. So this screw here and this screw here will have to be removed. Also, right behind that, right behind those two screws, there is a little bracket or a spacer. That spacer goes in between the bracket that holds the smog pump and the bracket that holds the power steering pump. Make sure you know how that goes back in. If you drop it and forget how it goes, if you're mechanically inclined, you'll probably be able to figure out how it goes back on, but just make sure that that goes on properly. I do want to mention on the bottom screw here that goes through both of the plates, it's basically going to go through the plate that holds the smog pump first, then it goes through the bracket, then it goes through the plate that holds the power steering pump, and then it goes into the water pump. So I hope that helps you out. Also on this side, you'll notice that you'll have two hoses. One of the hoses is a thin hose. It goes to the, or comes out of the water pump and into the firewall, which is basically where your heater core is. And then there's another small hose that basically comes out of the water pump and into the top of the exhaust manifold, into the top of the intake manifold. But you'll notice that once you get into the job. So those are just some other real quick tips and where to locate the screws on the driver's side of the vehicle. All right, that basically concludes the tutorial. I hope it's helped you out. There are a couple things I wanted to mention. On the bottom of the water pump, there's a big hose that comes off of there, and it goes to the radiator. You may consider replacing that hose, and then, you may consider replacing any hoses that haven't been replaced recently. The reason is because you don't want to go through a job like this, and you put new antifreeze in there and everything, and then a hose blows on you, and you lose all that antifreeze, and you have to go buy it again and fill it up and all that kind of crazy stuff. So any hoses that haven't been replaced in a while, just go ahead and replace them. It's just an easy thing to do. The other thing I wanted to mention was when you take the old water pump off, you'll probably have a lot of gasket still remaining on the vehicle. Make sure you clean that off as best as you possibly can. You may even get some gasket sealer, or not gasket sealer, some gasket remover. The kind that I've used in the past is this stuff right here. I don't know if you can see it. Gasket remover. Comes in a green can. You shake it up, you spray it on there, leave it sit for a while, and it really helps to remove the gasket a lot easier than if you just try to scrape it off. The type of silicone that I use, RTV silicone, it is the red silicone, which is basically the high temp silicone. You just want to use a small bead. Basically, you put a small bead on the water pump, then you put your gasket down, then you put another small bead on the gasket, let that sit for 10 minutes so it'll cure really well, and then you're ready to put the water pump back on the vehicle. This process, it does take some patience, it takes some time, so if you're not one that has time or patience, you might consider having someone else do this. But when my mechanic told me it was going to cost me $200 to do the job, I thought to myself, nah, I'm going to do that one myself. I had done it in the past, so I already knew what I was getting into. But anyway, that concludes the tutorial. Again, I hope it's helped you out. If you have any comments or questions, or if I've missed something, definitely feel free to post it. I'll do my best to answer your comments or questions. And as always, have a great day, and I'll talk to you soon.